It's no secret that in the state of California and many other states, Illinois leads the list, that the promises made decades ago to public employee pensions were not sustainable. It's very difficult to do much about people who are already retired. California law says that once you're retired, most law says, you have a vested right. Changing that, no one's figured out how to do that. There's a case before the California Supreme Court and other states where there's possibilities of changing pension rights to those people who started work for future work. As of today, that's not there. The problem is not just that the pensions are overly generous. The problem is it takes money from other subjects which we really believe in. Marin County people are not anti-government people. They're not. They want government services. Not only do they want them, they want first class because they expect first class in most parts of their life. So they want good services. It takes money to provide good services. But a lot of that money, unfortunately, has been diverted. Huge amounts of percentages of cash flow is diverted to sustain pensions. It's at some point it'll explode and implode, but it's not going to happen for a while. I'm a great fan of the Marin County Citizens for Sustainable Pensions. They come up with 5 points which should not be threatening either side of the argument. I'm going to read them. But their ideas of at least addressing the public's awareness of what's happening. 5 points. One, hire outside negotiators. I can tell you, when I was a council member of the city of Mill Valley, we had an outside negotiator come in. It's not an odd concept. Not doing it in-house. We simply hired a person who did this, and by the trust of the city manager, and because we had a great city manager, council trusted the city manager, and we had a good relationship. Outside negotiator. Two, independent auditor. We ought to know what this is all going to cost. We ought to know what it's going to cost. Not a radical idea. Most city managers and professionals in the pension business, I was a pension trustee for 10 years, for 9 years, with the Golden Gate Bridge with our Amalgamated Transit Workers Union, bus drivers. We want to know what this stuff's going to cost. You should want to know what this stuff's going to cost as members of the public. Hire an auditor to tell you what it's going to cost. Three, transparent. Disclose offers and counteroffers as it's going back. The trick is not to present a fait accompli. We had no choice. The public, I'd be fine with the prospect. They don't have to have any right to sit down in a negotiating room. But when correspondence comes, and that's another point, the correspondence comes, or the offer, official offer, and official counteroffers, with a fait accompli. And finally, leave enough time when the deal's made to put it on the agenda for the public has right to consider. 5 points, hardly radical. Doesn't really, shouldn't disturb anybody who doesn't believe in transparency in government. And the answer is, why doesn't each, or I should say, why doesn't, because it's fairly recent, we should urge all 11 cities and the county to adopt this. One by one, take a look at these 5 points, and adopt it. I'm optimistic that most of our cities will see their wisdom and do that. The county is a different story, but again, I have great faith in the ability of the cities to be responsive and actually to understand the problem, because these are folks. The city folks are the ones closest to understand they can't provide the parks the way they want. They can't take care of the media strips the way they want. They can't handle planning with a really thorough analysis that needs of us paying a lot of money. And so you take that money away, the pay to pensions, which runs the state, which can't do any of that stuff. Toronto's facing that right now with a tax amount that's going to address flood control. They're already paying flood control. And so there's not enough money because the money can be given to the person. It's just a problem which needs to be addressed. And one way to do it is adopting 5 points.